绪，太漫长却止不住去天涯间。
Namo Amitabha Buddha. Hello everyone. So today I'd like to share another well-known rebirth case. It's the rebirth case of Lady Yueguo. So in the Song dynasty in China, there was the lady called Lady Yueguo who was the wife of the head of state. So her husband was actually the uncle of the emperor at that time. So she was of course very wealthy and noble, and she had lots of servants serving her. So she really did not have so much to do. And she encountered the Dharma and also the Pure Land Dharma, and she took belief in Amitabha Buddha and the Pure Land instantly. And so she decided to practice Nianfo, and not only she would practice Nianfo, but she would also invite all the servants to come and practice Nianfo together and to seek rebirth together. So there was one servant who was quite lazy. Sometimes she practiced and sometimes she didn't want to practice. And Lady Yueguo became quite angry with her and told her, "You should practice Nianfo diligently." And the servant became really diligent afterwards because she didn't want to make Lady Yueguo angry again. And the servant actually sought rebirth to the Pure Land much earlier than all the other servants. So after the servant sought rebirth, she sent a dream to another servant who was her very best friend. So what happens is when you seek rebirth to the Pure Land, you can come back in one instant. You can manifest in other people's dreams and to let them know that you have actually sought rebirth to the Pure Land. So this is exactly what happened. So she told the other servant in her dream that she had already sought rebirth to the Pure Land. "Please thank Lady Yueguo for me. The life in the Pure Land is just so wonderful, so blissful. I'm so grateful for Lady Yueguo. Without her telling me, I would not have known about this, and I'm so grateful for her. Please thank her for me." So when the servant woke up the next day, she told Lady Yueguo about the dream. So Lady Yueguo was happy to hear that, but she also said, "Well, doesn't she know me personally? If she really seeks rebirth, why doesn't she come and thank me personally?" "Well, I don't believe her. Tell her to come and thank me personally." So on that evening, the person who sought rebirth actually came into Lady Yueguo's dream. So what happens is when you are in the Pure Land, you will obtain all these psychic abilities and you will be able to know the thoughts of other beings in different words. So she actually came into Lady Yueguo's dream. And she told Lady Yueguo, "Thank you so much, Lady Yueguo, for telling me about Amitabha Buddha and the Pure Land. I'm so grateful for you, and now I'm in the Pure Land, and I really enjoy my life here, so thank you so much." And Lady Yueguo was very happy to see her, and Lady Yueguo said, "Oh really, you are really in the Pure Land. Can you please take me to the Pure Land as well?" And she said, "Yes, of course, follow me." So again, once you are in the Pure Land, you will be able to also show other people the Pure Land. So Lady Yueguo followed her in the Pure Land. First, she showed her the Seven Jewel Lotus Pond. Like now, we're currently studying the Amitabha Sutra, where it mentioned the Seven Jewel Lotus Pond. That is where we will be manifested through the lotus once we seek rebirth to the Pure Land. So on the Seven Jewel Lotus Pond, she saw many beautiful lotuses. And there are also the names of the people who will seek rebirth to the Pure Land. So what happens is that in our world or in any other world, if there is a person who kneel for and take belief in Amitabha Buddha, and immediately your lotus will be open in the Seven Jewel Lotus Pond. And the more we kneel for, the more we deepen our cultivation, the bigger the lotus will be. So it's like we can actually grow our lotus in the Pure Land now if we practice more diligently, or if we transfer more merits towards seeking rebirth to the Pure Land, then our lotus will be bigger and brighter. And after a while, Lady Yueguo saw a person called Yang Jie. So Yang Jie was a government official at that time who was also a devout lay Buddhist. So she saw his incarnation already sitting on his own lotus. So what happens is, if your faith is really so deep, it's unshakable, you have obtained one-heartedness in Nianfo, like your rebirth is definitely guaranteed, and your incarnation is already there in the Pure Land. It's not a joke, it's not sci-fi. The technology in the Pure Land is much, much more advanced than our current state of technology, than any kind of sci-fi that the people in this world could have imagined. If you want the best sci-fi imagination, you need to go and read the sutras, but this is actually real. It's not sci-fi, it's not any movies. So she already saw Yang Jie's incarnation was there, and then she was like, oh, that's Yang Jie, I knew him. And then after she worked for a while, she also saw another person she knew, so it was Ma Yu, also another government official at that time, also a devout lay Buddhist who practiced Nianfu diligently. And then she asked, where is my lotus? Do I have a lotus? And the servant said, yes, of course, come with me. And then after a while, they walked to another seven jewel lotus pond, and then they saw this big, huge golden lotus there, and also other little lotus around this golden lotus. And then she told her, so the golden lotus is actually your lotus. So when we near for our lotus will already be grown in the seven jewel lotus pond in the Pure Land, and there will be our names on it. So the servant showed Lady Yueguo, this is your golden lotus. So golden lotus represents the highest grade of high rebirths. Like those who obtain high grade of rebirth, they will have the golden lotus. And this is also because of bodhicitta. So not only that they cultivate for themselves, but they really want to share the message to others. So because Lady Yueguo has great bodhicitta, so not only she practiced, but she also told all her servants to practice. So this really generated great merit to her. And that is why her lotus was very big, bright, and it was golden, beautiful color. And all those little lotus around her were all the servants who practiced Nianfu thanks to her. So Lady Yueguo was so blissful, so joyous after she saw her own lotus. And then she woke up from the dream. And she became much more diligent in her own practice. And on her 80th birthday, while everyone was waiting for her to come out and celebrate, she already burned an incense and stood in front of the statue of Amitabha Buddha and sought rebirth to the Pure Land. So she actually sought rebirth by standing. And everyone was so amazed when I found out. And after that, many people also took belief in Amitabha Buddha and the Pure Land because of her rebirth case. So you can seek rebirth in any position you like. You can lie down or sitting. A lot of people went to the Pure Land by sitting, or you can do it by standing. So there were also quite a lot of cases where people just stood and sought rebirth to the Pure Land. So this is, I found, also quite an inspiring case. And if we want to obtain a high grade of rebirth in the Pure Land, then what we need to do is to cultivate Nianfu diligently and also to try to share the message of Amitabha Buddha with as many people as possible. And there are definitely great benefits associated with beings who obtain high grade of rebirth. One will realize Buddhahood much sooner once one arrives in the Pure Land. So I'll also share another video about the 9 grade of rebirth in the future, which we also discussed before in our weekly Dharma talks. So if you want to know more about the Pure Land, the life in the Pure Land, and the beings in the Pure Land, you can come to our weekly Sutra and Dharma discussions on Thursday morning, 8 a.m. and also Sunday afternoon, 3 p.m. So currently we're talking about the Amitabha Sutra, and feel free to join us anytime. So may all beings hear the name of Amitabha Buddha and be reborn in the land of ultimate bliss in one lifetime to liberate from all sufferings in life. Namo Amitabha Buddha. Namo Amitofo.